Okay, we started an NTV in the late 90s. We saw what was happening in the Middle East, where the first generation entrepreneurs started a lot of companies, a lot of web portals, hired 50 employees plus, and did a mega investment to start this. With the collapse of the dot-coms, everyone realized that you have to have a business model. There is no infrastructure in the Middle East to support online entrepreneurship. And what happened is that many of those companies that started in the late 90s collapsed. At that time, we started building infrastructure companies. We realized that big part of their failure was that they were trying to do everything themselves. So what we've done is that we've established a company for online advertisement called NetAdvantage, a company for online payment called OneCard. We had our own internet service providers and such. So we started catering for online entrepreneurship and supporting entrepreneurs and small businesses online to make money. Since 2002, NTV generated millions of dollars to a lot of entrepreneurs, to tens or hundreds of entrepreneurs in the region in terms of advertisement revenue, e-services revenue, and such. What we've realized is that only very few number of those entrepreneurs were able to utilize this money to actually grow their businesses and grow their sites and hire employees and grow it to a level that the potential is for it to grow. When we went back and discussed this with those tens of entrepreneurs, we found that it wasn't only the money that is needed. It's not a magical formula where a venture capital will just come and give the entrepreneur the money and he will be able to do it. The region here is still missing a lot of infrastructure. They're still missing a lot of maturity. They're still missing a lot of things that are needed for those entrepreneurs to be able to excel. So when we discussed with them, they needed mentorship. They needed support. They needed offices. They needed support to hire employees. They needed ability to grow geographically. They needed marketing arm. They needed PR arm. They needed a lot of things for them to excel in what they do best. In addition to some maturity when it comes to investment, in terms of vesting equity, in terms of stock options, in terms of all those kind of things. We've been very successful so far. The quality of entrepreneurs we've been meeting was amazing. The industry as a whole, whether them entrepreneurs, venture capitalists, governments even, still need some maturity to go through, still need to learn a lot about online entrepreneurship. There's still a lot of misconceptions about how things should be done here. We cannot just take a US model and come and apply it here. You cannot just go and expect that as a venture capital, you need to find a company with a CEO and a CFO and 3 years audited financials and such that is doing a website. Simply the market is not big enough for that. And this is why many VCs were complaining about the lack of deal flow here in the region. This is why we think that things should happen here in the region in a different way. So the Middle East have a huge potential when it comes to online businesses. Now, if you look at e-commerce potential in the Middle East, it's a multi-billion dollar business. If you look at gaming, it is already in hundreds of millions and the potential for it to grow more. If you look at mobile and SMS and value-added services, it's a huge multi-billion dollar industry. If you look at social networks, if you look at any one of those verticals, there is a huge potential in the Middle East for them to succeed. But they will not succeed as, you know, fragmented, small initiatives that grow organically. They have to get together, they have to work together, they have to help promote each other, they have to get support from governments, from investors, from others, for this to grow to the size it should. And the opportunity is huge. And if the pent-up demand for it with the growth of the internet penetration is also huge. And if we don't cater for this as Middle Eastern companies, multinationals will just come and pick up this. And Amazon will eventually become in Arabic and others. Facebook is already in Arabic and other sites. So if we don't do big enough businesses in the meanwhile, it's all going to go to multinational companies that are not going to benefit the region here, not in revenues, not in work. Workforce, not in anything to that extent.